In this example, we will calculate the bubble temperature for a binary system. We're given the mole fractions of liquid phase, we're given the pressure, and what we want to determine is the temperature of the mole fractions of the vapor phase. So we're also given saturation pressure dependence on temperature. We're here at the units that are appropriate for this equation. Because the liquid phase is non-ideal, we need to pick some model to determine the activity coefficients. And so we're going to use the two-parameter Van Laar equation. And the two parameters were also given for this equation. And so I've written down the Van Laar relations that allow us to determine the activity coefficient. This corrects the liquid phase non-ideality. And so then we're ready to solve the equations for vapor liquid equilibrium. Since you were using modified Raoult's law, which is x1 gamma 1 p1 sat is equal to y1 times p, and then corresponding equation for component 2. And we're going to solve these equations by using a nonlinear equation solver. So first we want to look and determine, so here's one of our equations. Here's the second. Four equations. This is the fifth and the sixth. And the question is how many variables do we have? Well, we don't know gamma 1 or gamma 2. We don't know y1 nor y2. Temperature is one of the main things we're trying to solve for. And then we don't know p1 sat and p2 sat. So we have seven unknowns. Right now, six equations. Our seventh equation is that the mole fractions of y1 plus y2 must add to 1. So now seven equations and seven unknowns. We're going to substitute these into the nonlinear equation solver in polymath. And I'll just look at one of them to demonstrate how we do this. We essentially say there's some function, and we want that function to be zero. So for this first, for equation 5, it means x1 gamma 1 p1 sat minus y1p. That's what we want to be zero. The way polymath is set up is we need to put one of the variables in here. Could be y1, or it could be temperature. All that matters is we write down the seven equations so that each of these functions has a different unknown, and each of these equations, the seven equations, are on the right side. Then we'll make initial guesses for these seven unknowns and use the iteration in polymath to make all of these as close to zero as possible, and therefore find the best solutions to the equation. So we've done that in polymath, and here are the equations that were typed in. Information was given, pressure, the mole fraction of the liquid. The parameters for the Van Laar equation now are two Antoine equations. So you can see we have function, one of the variables. We've rearranged the Antoine equation so this would be zero. Same here. Here is the modified Raoult's law. We put temperature here, we put y1 here. Again, it's arbitrary as long as we have all of the unknowns. And then the equation for the gammas, the from Van Laar's model, and then the fact that 1 minus y1 minus y2 should also be zero. In polymath, we put our initial guesses in by indicating a variable, and then in parentheses, putting a zero, and on the right side, putting our guess. So we're guessing 0.5 for each of the mole fractions. We're guessing saturation pressures and gammas. We're guessing a temperature. Then we tell it to solve. And here's the results. So here are our guesses. This is what we showed in the equation. Here's the result of this equation that we want to be equal to zero. And you can see these are really very close to zero in every case. And then here are our final answers. They're certainly not accurate to this many significant figures. This is just what comes out of polymath. Temperature, and then the mole fraction. So we're enriched since x1 is 0.4 and y1 is 0.69. We're enriched in component 1. It's significantly non-ideal from the value for gamma 1. And there's a corresponding video that describes in more detail using polymath to solve this equation.